How's it going, everyone? This is MOS Tricks, and in this video we're going to be talking about how to use your Ki Blast properly while fighting in Dragon Ball Sparking Zero. And I can say, as someone who's been coaching fighting games for almost 6 years at this point, that this is one of the things that a lot of players are getting wrong while playing the game and trying to actually win, whether it's in ranked or even just using it against CPUs. First and foremost, you need to understand that using your Ki Blast is your neutral. Yes, you can get up close and personal with a lot of characters, and some characters have insanely good combos up close, but your neutral and your poking game is done with your Ki Blasts. So what does that mean? What does it mean for your Ki Blast to be your neutral? While in a game like Dragon Ball Sparking Zero, your Ki Blasts are your poke. Your Ki Blasts are your ability to interrupt your opponent and also stop them from using specials, or also call them out for using things like perception or even getting behind them for free damage. So step number one as far as using your Ki Blast is going to be knowing when to use a single Ki Blast to interrupt your opponent versus actually spamming them. And this is something that is extremely underrated, and that is to use a single Ki Blast to simply interrupt your opponent whenever they want to try and do something or get some sort of offense going. For example, right here, you saw the Raccoon player throw out a couple Ki Blasts right before going into instant sparking, and that was actually enough to stagger me so that he could get it off and then also go into a special right here. So it was good that he actually used those Ki Blasts first so he could go into instant sparking rather than getting interrupted, but the one mistake that he did make is the next thing we're going to talk about, and that is actually confirming your specials by using your Ki Blasts. Depending on the specials that your character has, if you throw out Ki Blasts first, you can get the opponent to try and deflect them, and if they are in that deflecting animation, they cannot instantly block. So what he could have done there is distract me with Ki Blasts and then go for his ultimate, and it probably would have landed. The next thing regarding Ki Blasts and neutral is paying attention to your spacing. And yes, in Arena Fighters, you have an auto lock on when you go for your melee attacks. However, when you have a little bit of distance between each other and you're able to use your dashes, your spacing actually matters a ton because your Ki Blasts have travel time. Since your Ki Blasts do not travel instantly from you to your opponent, they can become very ineffective and waste your Ki if you're doing them at too far of a distance. Of course, as we've seen, we've also had it used against us as well, if somebody spams Ki Blasts from across the entire map, it's very easy to dodge them or deflect them. And if you didn't know, if you deflect a Ki Blast, it actually gives you meter towards your skill stocks. So if somebody wants to spam Ki Blasts from a mile away, I highly recommend deflecting them and getting your skill stocks up as much as you can, because of course it gives you access to your skills, and also if your character happens to transform or have fusions, it just makes your life even easier. So what you want to do instead is make sure that you're at an appropriate range so that the enemy has to guess or choose without actually knowing what's going to happen. Are they going to commit to going for a charge? Or are they going to try and deflect or reposition in the event that you might use a Ki Blast? At a certain distance, if we want to call it mid-range, so just outside of the step-in barrier, if someone tries to charge their Ki, then you can use a Ki Blast on reaction and actually punish them before they can block. But you definitely have to be careful here, because this is where the single Ki Blast comes into play. If they charge their Ki at mid-range and you spam Ki Blast, they can punish you with an ultimate or a special if you're not careful. So instead, what you want to do is stay at that mid-range, and if you're not actually sure what they're going to do, you do that single jab Ki Blast. One Ki Blast, reposition, see what they're going to do. Another Ki Blast, reposition, see what they're going to do. Something else that you just saw here as well is using Ki Blast to get an opening. One of the best ways to use Ki Blast is to circle around your enemy while using them, because if they want to sit in one position and deflect, if they're not rotating with you, they're going to get caught, and you can actually get some sizable damage, or you can actually dash in after it and then try and go for a combo. This works especially well if somebody is very scared of getting hit by Ki Blast, because you've been just lighting them up for the majority of the match and taking so much free damage because they're not deflecting them. So what can happen here is they're trying to make a read on you. They think that if you get to a certain distance, you're probably just going to start spamming Ki Blast, and if that's the case, they're going to try their best to get some skill stocks, in which case you can probably open them up for free, or at least reposition and get behind them with a vanishing assault. So we've talked a lot about using Ki Blast as far as neutral and a little bit as far as offensively, but one of the best ways to use them defensively is if you happen to be going for a combo and they end up blocking whatever you're doing. One of the best ways to use them is after you hear that blocking sound, just back up with Ki Blast, because a lot of players go from blocking and then they try and go into perception. So if they end up blocking your attacks before they get the chance to Sonic Sway or use perception against you, try on reaction to back up with Ki Blast and get some very, very easy damage. If you play a character like Majin Vegeta or one of the androids or somebody who can just do multiple Ki Blasts in succession, you could be racking up 4,000 or 5,000 damage very quickly. Of course, not every character can do that, but if you're playing against somebody who was very hyper-focused on using perception, then by all means, back up and use Ki Blast to get some free damage. So we've talked a lot about the spacing and the strategy and the neutral and some offense and some defense, but also we gotta pay attention to actually actually managing our ki, so we're not in a situation where we have absolutely zero ki. Because a couple bad things can happen if we are under one bar of ki. The first and most obvious that I'm sure has happened to many of you is you find yourself in a vanishing chain and then you instantly lose because every time you vanish, it takes ki and you have none. Another thing that happens, but not nearly as frequently, is that if you are under a bar of ki and someone lands a heavy smash on your guard, you will go into burnout. Burnout simply means that you are going to stand there in a tired stance where you cannot do anything until you mash out of that stance. So there's a couple things that we absolutely have to pay attention to. The number one thing is, before we go in to actually engage with our enemy, see how much ki they actually have. If we find ourselves in a vanishing chain, are we going to instantly lose? Another thing we want to try and do is make sure that we're not spamming our ki so we find ourselves in a horrific situation at mid and long range, because most of the time the enemy is going to have time to deflect or just move, so don't waste your ki while you're trying to approach. And lastly, if you find your opponent trying to charge to get to a point where they can go into sparking, absolutely do not spam your ki blasts to try and stop them. If you shoot out multiple, they do not travel faster. What you want to do is make sure that you're never so far away that if they go into instant spark, there's literally nothing that you can do. What you want to try and do is make them earn it. If they happen to land a vanish on you and they win the vanish war and they instantly go into it, then fair play. If they happen to throw you away and then not chase you and they get to use their instant spark there, also fair play. But you don't want to find yourself in a situation where you've backed up so far that they can just do it and nothing bad happens to them. Also, when you're in a situation like this, let's call it max distance, you want to make sure that you're not using all of your ki so that if they happen to go for an instant spark after they deflected everything, you now have no ability to Z-burst dash towards them or even shoot a single ki blast to stop them. This is extremely important if they have max ki already. If you are blasting away at a distance and you find yourself with no ki and you can't even dash towards them, you just played yourself. Also keep in mind that basically no characters in the game have the ability to instantly attack you or kill you in an unreactable way from across the entire map. There's either going to be a cutscene or whatever they do, you will have time to react. So there's absolutely no reason to panic and use all of your ki blasts to try and do any sort of damage at max range. It simply does not work. One thing that I always do when I find myself at max range is look at my enemy's health and meters. Are they about to use something that I cannot detect, like after image strike or wild sense? You have to pay attention to those things, and if you know at max range you are never in danger, there's no reason why you can't take a look at the top right of your screen to see, did they pop a special skill or are they about to go into sparking and I'm just letting it happen? So what I like to do here is single tap my ki blasts while keeping an eye on their meters and drift towards them to close the gap. This way they can't go into instant sparking, and as I get closer to them, I know what I'm signing up for if they happen to use some skills and I know what their character does. If you have a suggestion for a video topic, please be sure to comment it down below. Hopefully you learned something new from this video, and as always, have a great day.